The vice chairman and deputy secretary general of PDP-Laban not recognizing their supposed expulsion from the party. Alfonso Cusi, PDP-Laban vice chairman energy secretary, insists they were not kicked out. He claims party president Senator Manny Pacquiao had no authority to expel any member, nor did the committee that ordered their removal. Cusi is also calling Pacquiao's actions a cheap political gimmick. Cusi, along with Deputy Secretary General Melvin Matibag, were removed last week for supposedly violating several provisions of PDP-Laban's constitution. Matibag says the move is against the party's bylaws.
Yung ginawa pong nilang aksyon na yan, na pagpapatalsik daw sa amin, ay labag po sa bylaws ng atin pong partido. Kasi naman po, wala naman pong disciplining authority ang National Executive Council. Lalong higit, yung pong committee na yan ay committee lamang na create po ni Senator Manny Pacquiao. Maliwanag po sa bylaws ng PDP, Article 7, sinasabi ron, yung pong pagdisiplina sa mga miyembro, ang pwede lang pong gumawa niyan ay ang chapter kung saan sila napabibilang o kung saan National Council po sila napapaloob.
Developments like this will further deepen the factions within the party. So, yun ang nakakapag-worry na sana, kasi pag nag-expel na, parang nawawala na yung opportunity for dialogue. So sana magkausap nga talaga na, or magkaroon man lang ng consultation to the members, and then whatever happens there, everybody respects because that's the membership that has decided.
Party Chairman President Rodrigo Duterte has been on the offensive against Pacquiao for criticizing the administration. The senator has also been engaged in a word war against Cusi after a party meeting in May resulted in a resolution urging Duterte to seek the vice presidency in next year's national election. Quirino Governor Dakila Cua explains why he supported that resolution.
I think ang importante kasi ngayon, if there's ang importante ngayon na may pandemya, no? I'm thinking about the Filipino people. Ang pananaw ko kasi, the people are not so into politics now. They're thinking about hanap buhay. Ang daming ibang mas mahalagang tanong. I think the president can help reduce those pangangamba about the future, those uncertainties. Because he remains to be a figure that a lot of Filipinos support.
Former Commission on Elections Commissioner Gregorio Larrazabal bashed for joining the consultative tour of Senator Panfilo Lacson and Senate President Vicente Soto III in Luzon. The tour reportedly planning to run as a tandem in next year's elections. But Larrazabal insists he believes in the senators' post-pandemic recovery programs, especially for the countryside. Larrazabal adds he was also offered a spot in their ticket should he decide to join the Senate race.
I think if they decide to throw in their hats in the political scene for 2022, based on what I've heard, no, I think it's going to be good for the Philippines because we have to take a look at it from the point of view of how do we overcome the pandemic? How do we jumpstart the economy after? I like their programs, and they even mentioned that if I decide to throw in my hat in the Senate race, I'll be in their ticket. But I'm seriously looking at it.
Larrazabal says Lacson and Soto will be announcing their potential candidacies on August 5.